Hello guys, this is Mr. Hager with another Chromebook tutorial, and today we're going to talk a little bit about Google Drive. But first of all, before we get into that, I want to talk to you a little bit about how you can figure things out on the Chromebook or any computer or any program. So things always change. Google is changing, Apple is changing, the world is changing. Computers are always changing, and you're going to have to figure things out as you grow up with new devices on all of that kind of stuff. I'm sure that you already have an idea about how to figure things out on your cell phones and different things, but some suggestions I would suggest would be to just try to figure it out yourself. Poke around, press buttons, look at menus. Just try to figure it out yourself. If you right click on things, often there will be a window that pops up and will give you some options. Second suggestion is to ask somebody else, like another student, a neighbor, a friend, and they will likely be able to tell you. The second thing that you can, or the third thing you can do, is to Google it. And I often do this when I'm working on various issues with computers. So how do I change the background on my Chromebook? Google it, and you will find a quick answer from Google. So those are three different things that I suggest when you're trying to figure something out on your on any device. So let's talk a little bit about Drive. Let me switch over here to Tristan. Has shared his Drive with me, and so that we can see a student view. So here is a student's Drive, and you'll notice that there's a whole bunch of pre-made folders here. Well, these folders are made by a program called Hapara. Hapara is a program that teachers use to create folders that are shared with the student and the teacher. And they're also can be used for a whole bunch of different things. So for example, here's my Hapara dashboard. You can see my classes. I can go into one of my classes and see basically a snapshot of all of the students in my class and documents in my this happens to be a digital design class, and so far we don't have any documents in their folders, but I would be able to see them if they're in that folder. I can see into their Gmail. I can go into and see what they're doing right now on their Chromebook. I can also go in and grab their email addresses. And so it's basically a management program that allows teachers to do things and to track students and to communicate with them and see what's in their folders. So back in Tristan's folder, we have lots of different things that we can go into. So for example, on his Flex folder, so fourth period Flex, this is Tristan's folder. It's shared with his Flex teacher, and we can create a new file in this folder. So anytime you want to create something new in Drive, you go up to this blue new button. Now I can create another folder within the folder if I want. Let's do that. I'm just going to put test. So now I see, we'll see another folder in this folder. And you'll notice that this icon, a folder with a little person on it, means it's shared with somebody. So this is shared with Tristan's fourth period Flex teacher. Now if I go in here, I can make a document. Let's just make a Google Doc that lives within this folder. It will tell you that you're creating a document inside a shared folder and say yes. So here's the document. Little tip when you're on a new document and you type the title of the document at the top, you can actually click on the document name up here, and it will take that first line and put it up here. So then you can type out your essay, etc., and it will be shared in that folder. So let's take a look at this little path up here, which is important to know about. You're in your Drive. This is the folder that you're in, and here's another folder And we're looking inside that folder. So there's actually a folder within a folder inside Drive. So what happens if I want to trash this? You can do it a couple different ways. So if I'm inside, looking at a document, you can go up to File, Move to Trash, and that will move this document into the trash. Another way to do it is to look in Drive, and you can just drag and drop things over to the trash like that. So if I drag this document over, it'll trash it. Now, if I drag a folder over to the trash, it will trash the folder and all of the documents. Everything that's inside that folder will be gone, will be put into the trash. So I'll just do that because I don't want Tristan to see some strange folder in there. Anyways, so that is it. I want you to practice making, checking out your Drive to see all of the different pre-made folders that you have for your classes, as well as make a new folder and create a document to go into that folder to practice. All right, until next time, I'll talk to you later.